Welcome back from that break. You're still watching Urban Magazine with myself, Lynn Komjisha. Now, just like the rest of the world, sports in Uganda has been bedridden for some time as a result of COVID-19. At the beginning of 2020, a lot of sporting activities and federations had a lot of plans with more focus on Olympics 2020 that were to be held in Tokyo, Japan, between July and August this year. In February, the Uganda Boxing Federation had their Olympics boxing qualifiers in Dakar, Senegal, where one of the boxers, Shadil Musa Bouaji, qualified for the Tokyo Olympics 2020. The federation's other plan of qualifying boxers for the Olympics was through the World Boxing Olympics qualifiers in Paris in March, which was shattered after the outbreak of COVID-19, which led to the cancellation of the event. Oliver Nakate has the details of what took place throughout the COVID-19-ridden sporting year. In February, the Uganda Boxing Federation had the Olympics boxing qualifiers in Dakar, Senegal, where one of the boxers, Shadil Musa Bouaji, qualified for the Tokyo Olympics 2020.
I like the intensity.
And there it is.
Love that.
Bouaji.
The federation's other plan of qualifying boxers for the Olympics was through the World Boxing Olympics qualifiers in Paris in March, which were shattered after the outbreak of COVID-19 that led to the cancellation of the event. In the same month of February, Joshua Cheptegei broke the world record in the 5-kilometer race in 12 minutes and 51 seconds. This seemed like the beginning of Uganda's quest for world victory. However, Uganda's search for world glory was cut short by the outbreak of COVID-19. In March, the government declared a total ban on all sporting activities as a way of curbing the spread of COVID-19. The ban on sports was global, as many international major events, among them Olympics Tokyo 2020, World Youth Netball Cup, and World Woodball Cup. The year also saw Vipers crowned champions of the 2019-2020 Uganda Premier League in May with 54 points after the league ended abruptly. Despite the ban on sports, athletics brought joy to many Ugandans, as many Ugandan athletes like Joshua Cheptegei, Jacob Kiplimo, Halima Nakai, and Winnie Nanyondo were able to participate in a number of international events. In 2020, it serves right to declare that Joshua Cheptegei is the sports personality of the year, basing on the various victories he's brought home. Cheptegei broke 3 world records, the 5-kilometer race, 10,000 meters race, and the 5,000 meters race. Cheptegei's target now is winning a gold medal in the Olympics 2021 to be declared Uganda's greatest athlete of all time.
The Olympic Games is just 7 months away from now, and we are laying a foundation and we have started training, and we hope that we can do best as a country, as an individual. So I believe that I have goals to chase for 2021. I don't want to miss out on the gold medal of the Olympic Games. And we are really doing well. We are really starting training with the help of our coach, Adi Ruita, with the help of Global Sports Communication. We believe that we will do something amazing.
Jacob Kiplimo deserves a mention for winning the 3,000-meter Wanda Diamond League in Rome, winning the World Half Marathon in Gdynia, Poland, and finishing second at Valencia Half Marathon.
With record-setting performances in the men's 3,000.
Early September saw the Ugandan government lift the ban on sporting activities, paving the way for Uganda Cranes to participate in the African Cup of Nations qualifiers against South Sudan. Uganda won 1-0 against Sudan at St. Mary's Stadium, Chitende, only to be surprised by a 1-0 loss in Kenya. 2021 will be one of the most competitive years in all sporting events. First, it is an Olympics year, with the Olympics set to be held in Japan, Tokyo, between July and August 2021, the Africa Cup of Nations 2021 in Cameroon, African Netball Championships, and World Youth Netball Cup in Fiji.
The day, 29th December 2020, will always be remembered by the boxing fraternity as a day former boxing captain Zebra Senyange was gunned down by unknown assassins. Senyange was attacked by unknown assassins at his residence in Boise Tuesday night.
A lot of words can't explain and describe the man he was. He was really a true legend and a hero in the game. Right now, I'm too confused and scared about who will be the next one to walk in his foots. Because he's been a man of his words. He could talk and everyone listen about everything he talks. Now we're just left hanging because no one we can fix in that gap. The game will also fail to get anyone or another person who will sit down or will talk like him. Because he's been a man of his word. He helped me to qualify for Olympics. I remember he took me in the camp where I was training alone. And I used to train with him. Right now he's no more. It's too sad that I'm going for Olympics without his guidance.
I think it's even irreplaceable because it's not easy to find a person of a character like Mando's. Zebra was an honest person, a courageous person, a confident person. He was someone who loved boxing for boxing. He wasn't here for money because all this time I've been working with him, he's not earning a salary from the Federation, but he was doing it because he loves boxing. So that way, that kind of character, the vacuum created is too big for us to fill. But of course, we have no choice, we have to move on. We have to look into the Federation members and see if we can find replacements for him. But it's going to be very hard and it will take some time.
Senyange was a Bombers captain in Africa Games held in Maputo, Mozambique in 2011. He has played amateur boxing for 15 years with 213 fights, won 195 and lost only 19. He turned professional in 2012 and retired from boxing in 2015.
Aba boxer ba Uganda bahantia zisizi gulo bangunza azanya zanya zisizanya zanya zisorosoro guno mukono ogula baguno zisiri muntu zini mwe chuma nina jaja wanga bamuita chuma ambera nange zisiri muntu ba muntu nyinza kuba muntu yate inamati zi style eyo je nkupeyi iyo yena kufomu ja kuba muntu rumafe ndina gambi ekintu ngena kuandike barua era chigame agala liko mfufugala igira kubukede ngena kuandike barua egende mu kitongere cha UPBC bajitwali mu ngena jiba itamu jibalage mu press conference. Njagalandeke bona Uganda obune pangira kubona mukubiru mubona kugu nakurumu buvewo mbambete champion wa Africa ne mukubafe njakubwa muntu wafe mulingi wakuba bantu mbagala bebambize mukama wapo niti batigira ndi mando muzibuzibu zinine chuma zindije ujaja chuma jaja wange chuma amanyi zichimwa nje kubwa muntu mule na mati zi style kubwa kubwa muntu bane kusirika kati gwangame ngena kuigiza yo panche mu bajiita va kugondi kumvaza dadi.
Senyange is survived by a wife and three children. He was laid to rest today at his ancestral home in Masulita. ...2020 will leave a mark on the history of sports for not only putting an end to sporting life, but also to serve as a lesson to sports federations to always have a way out in times like these. Though sports returned and still is returning with more events, the question of whether to allow fans into the stadium still remains.
That's all the time we had for. Thank you for watching Urban Magazine. My name is Lynn Komjisha. We want to once again wish you a very happy and prosperous New Year 2021. Don't forget, there's a repeat Monday, 8 a.m.